Hey everyone, Sam from Professional Music Technology here, and in this video I'm going to try and give you a simple answer to the question, what is MIDI 2.0? So prior to MIDI, which if you didn't know is an acronym for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, there was no real standardised way of getting instruments such as synths and drum machines to talk to each other. But in 1983, MIDI 1.0 was introduced and adopted by all the major manufacturers such as Roland, Yamaha and Korg as the first universal digital interface for instruments, which meant that there was now a really simple, standardised way to link, sync and control hardware devices and later on down the line software, regardless of different brands or the type of digital instrument. Now it's testament to how well thought out that original version of MIDI was, as nearly 40 years later, it's still pretty much the standard way of getting devices and software to talk to each other, and it's become an absolute essential for both recording studio setups as well as live performers. But now in 2020, however, MIDI has evolved with the announcement of MIDI 2.0. Now, the MIDI Manufacturers Association are calling this the biggest advance in music technology in decades. So to say the least, it's a pretty significant update with some pretty powerful, complex possibilities. But without going down that rabbit hole, today I'm just going to try and give you a really quick, simple explanation of the main benefits of MIDI 2.0. So one of the biggest upgrades for MIDI 2.0 is, whereas previously MIDI messages were only able to be sent in one direction over a single MIDI connection, so one device would be a transmitter and the other would be a receiver, with version 2.0, that monologue one-way conversation can now become a two-way dialogue between devices over that single MIDI connection. Now, before you start worrying that your existing MIDI gear has suddenly become redundant and obsolete, MIDI 2.0 is backwards compatible with older devices. So when you connect a MIDI 2.0 device to another MIDI unit, the first thing it will automatically do is determine whether the connected device supports MIDI 2.0. And if it doesn't, it will just continue communicating using MIDI 1.0 in the way that we're used to MIDI devices talking to each other. But if both devices are MIDI 2.0 compliant, it opens up a whole new world of possibilities. Firstly, the new MIDI Capability Inquiry, or MIDI CI messages, will allow MIDI 2.0 compatible devices to automatically talk to each other so they can understand each other's capabilities. MIDI Profile Configuration messages will then dynamically configure the device for a certain use. So for example, if a control surface inquires a device that has a mixer profile, then the controls will automatically map to faders, pan pots, and other parameters associated with a mixer. On the other hand, if that same control surface is connected to, let's say, an organ plugin with a drawbar profile, then the physical faders will automatically map to the virtual drawbars. So in a nutshell, it's going to drastically reduce setup times as it eliminates having to manually configure devices, which, as we all know, can be really tedious, especially when you're trying to configure your controller within a DAW with multiple plugins. So MIDI 2.0 should definitely improve your workflow and help make creating music between devices much more intuitive. On top of this, MIDI 2.0's property exchange messages will discover and retrieve specific information from another device, such as preset names, individual parameter settings, and other unique functionalities. This means, for example, you might be using a hardware synth connected to your computer, but if it's MIDI 2.0 compatible, your recording software will be able to automatically detect every single parameter from that synth and then display it on the computer screen, effectively giving your hardware synth the same level of recallability and in-depth editing as its soft synth counterpart. So along with these two-way MIDI capabilities, MIDI 2.0 also dramatically improves on the amount and speed of data that can actually be communicated between devices. Supporting up to 256 MIDI channels and 32-bit resolution, MIDI 2.0 means that communications between devices can now be much more complex, and this will make timing characteristics more reliable and less buggy, and control changes more efficient. That higher resolution allows for much more detailed control of parameters. Think of it this way. MIDI controls on version 1.0 allow for adjustments of a parameter between the range of 0 to 127. Now, with MIDI 2.0, this range goes into the thousands. So let's say you're controlling a parameter with either a fader or a knob on your control surface. Those adjustments are going to be much smoother and more precise, kind of how you'd expect an analog control knob to feel. Now extend that to every single knob, fader, pad and key on your control device, and it opens up a whole new world of expressive possibilities when creating or performing music. MIDI 2.0 has also been future-proofed to enable its functionality to evolve and expand over the years to come. Unlike the first incarnation of MIDI, which was initially tied to a specific hardware implementation, MIDI 2.0's new universal MIDI packet format makes it easily implemented onto any digital transport, such as USB or Ethernet. And to make sure it can be expanded to accommodate future applications, you know, the stuff that we can't even envision today, there's ample space reserved for the creation of brand new MIDI messages in the future. So hopefully, just like its predecessor, MIDI 2.0 will be the standard musical instrument digital interface for decades to come. So put simply, MIDI 2.0 isn't making version 1.0 obsolete. All of your old gear is still going to work just as it always has done. It's more of a huge expansion in functionality on the original version, with MIDI 2.0 devices offering a much more efficient workflow and allowing for much more complex programming and more dynamic performances. Obviously, MIDI 2.0 compatible devices are only just starting to hit the market, so it's still kind of in its infancy at the moment, and I've only really just touched on the possibilities that it can bring to the table. So it is going to be really exciting to see how manufacturers and software designers implement that expanded functionality in the years to come. But for now, for more information on MIDI 2.0 and compatible devices, visit pmtonline.co.uk or get down to your nearest professional music technology store and have a chat with one of our high-tech experts. As always, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. And if you did enjoy this video and found it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, ring the notifications bell, and I'll see you again soon.